is what?
Well, Jack Walker, the original saxophone player and the cat that's you can hear his voice on this CD in at least three right. different forms. Yeah,
not throughout. What meant what mean what it means. What meant like it's
you can hear him playing saxophone. Okay. You can hear him playing flute. But then you can also hear him speaking and doing some spoken word on a lot of these pieces in a very effective and profound way. But anyway, when we were first getting together and we were having rehearsals and like the third or fourth time we met, we were talking about names of the group, what should we call ourselves? And he said, yeah, I think we need to call it the group Iswhat, because it is what it is. Can't nobody pigeonhole what we doing, and we just coming out of a whole other box. I can see it. Now we're going to move with this thing. So that's what.
Just come out with a name like that. You know it's the right one.
Right.
Yeah, I agree with you, but I think a part of it, like what you're talking about, with the way that cats are acting, has a lot to do with what the market and what mainstream pop culture is kind of dictating to them that they should be. I'm not saying that they have to listen, but I can understand certain aspects of influence.
Yeah, but I think that, look, I mean, at the same time, you have to say to yourself that you. Okay, we all want to need to make money.
Yeah.
But you have to ask yourself at the same time, what do you want to live with in yourself in the future?
Right. Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
Today it sounds good. You got the money and all that. Okay, I don't know what the record labels are asking. They're asking for 360 deals now.
Right.
It means they want everything.
Yeah, they want a cut of everything. They want a cut everything. Of your merchandising. They want a cut of your touring. They want a cut of,
They want everything.
Yeah.
For doing what?
I guess depending on what marketability the artist has already, quote unquote, proven by selling, by making a certain amount of currency off of their brand or their commodity, then the labels will jump in and they'll say, okay, we know we can market this, and it's not even about like they're investing in the artist. They're re-ing up. They're flipping. You know, they're.
I think jazz musicians or so. You know, there we go again with the packaging because you know, and we fall into that too by categorizing the music, which a lot of the masters resisted their whole life.
Mm-hmm.
But since we're talking about it, just so we can be clear on what we're talking about. I mean, jazz musicians. You know, if they want to see financial rewards, and we were talking about this in Paris, they need to make their music valid.
Yeah.
You know, and that's the bottom line is if they want to reach a young audience, make music that young people are going to understand. Mm-hmm. And be smart about how you're going to market it to those people. You know, I mean, this is the age we live in, so there's many more tools for us to market things than there ever were. Now, that being said, there's also so much out there now that to cut through can be a really, really difficult, and you have to be very shrewd about how you do that. You know, you have make some music that means something that people want to listen to. And if people don't buy it, then you're still making something that means something to you.
Sure.
And that's what drives you in the first place.
Of course. That should be the reason why you get involved in music.
Right.
Yeah. And so,
if you don't like what you're doing, why should you
exactly,
go ahead?
Yes.
I mean, that's the great thing that Cocheme'a just said, because, I mean, especially if you're about the essence of the music, you know, if you're about the essence of the music, then style, and rhythm, style, sound, all those things are simply your servants, your tools. You're not a slave to them.
Yeah.
You know, you don't have to stay confined in this box saying that, you know, well, I can only do this particular type of thing. It has to sound this way for it to be authentic. You know, that's what a great way that's an amazing brainwashing.
Yeah, I mean, it's packaging, isn't it?
To think that in order for something to be authentic, it has to be like this. When these things are our servants.
Yeah.
You know, rhythm is a servant. Sound is a servant. Style is a servant. We don't want to be slaves to style, because that's the death of the two. Too, because it's almost like we have to have a revamping of things. Like Barack Obama says that everybody has to contribute. Now, Cocheme'a was a school teacher, you know, and with the kids 5 hours.
I respect that.
But then you gotta think about now in the American system, how many kids is that one teacher with?
Yeah, it's a
Everybody has to kind of step up, in a way to like, okay, but one teacher with 30, 35 kids, it's amazing that I think that the teachers are able to do what they do.
Well, that's why some of the men...
That's why we need these other programs where it's like we kind of step in and maybe can like kind of give some...
Take some relief away. Awesome.
Yeah, because it's man, and then a school teacher, man, it's like you got kids coming in with all kind of problems.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Personal problems.
And the personal problems, and I know they try and do the best they possibly can, but they can't address all of that, you know. And then trying to teach, you know, just basic education too.
Yeah.
You know, kids coming in from broken families, you know, I mean, all kind of stuff, you know. Maybe they're suffering some sort of abuse at home, or maybe they're who knows? You know? All kinds.